Need more energy? Want more happiness in your life? Want to be healthier and live longer?
To live long and healthy, to have plenty of energy and vitality, that's what we all want. The good news is, that's God's dream for your life as well. But we have to get in agreement with Him. Our emotional well-being affects our physical well-being.
When we live worried, stressed, or bitter, it weakens our immune system. It won't fight off disease like it should.
That's why I wrote my new book. I'll show you 15 things you can do to live healthier and longer. You can get up each morning with more energy. You can go to work with more vitality. You can be free from what's limiting your life.
You owe it to yourself and your family to be strong and healthy. Your first priority is to take care of yourself.
I know these principles work. I've used them in my own life. I still feel like I'm in my 20s. The scripture talks about how our youth can be renewed. That's our prayer for you, that you will feel younger, have plenty of energy, and live a long, vibrant life.
As you support the mission of Joel Osteen Ministries with a gift of any amount this month, we would like to give you a copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier. Studies have shown that prolonged stress can damage your health. However, when you are full of hope and joy, your immune system functions at its peak performance, just as God has intended. Your health can be restored, and energy to enjoy your life and family can return. And in this book, you'll explore how to have a calmer soul, a more focused mind, and you will learn to let go and how to best take care of yourself.
We don't always realize how much our emotions and attitudes are affecting us physically. If you want to be healthy, you have to make sure your soul is healthy.
I'd love to send you a copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier. We want you to feel better than ever, have more energy, more vitality, so you can become all you were created to be. Victoria and I pray for you and your family every day. Thank you so much for your support and your prayer. Your generosity is making a difference in people's lives around the world. Special thank you to our Champion of Hope partners for your monthly support. If you're not a partner, I hope you'll consider becoming one. Remember, you can watch the services live online every Sunday. You can download our daily podcast. Until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you.
Be sure to request your copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier today. Visit joelosteen.com or call 888-567-JOEL. Also this month, for additional donation, we have our Abundant Life Journal and Pen Set. You can write down what you need to let go of and declare new health that God is blessing you with. Also, our Abundant Life Wall Art Gift is a beautiful reminder of the amazing life God has for you. You can learn more about these life-giving gifts by calling 888-567-JOEL or logging on to joelosteen.com today. As you absorb these 15 ways to live longer and healthier, you'll experience a truly blessed life. Order your copy today and start each morning with more energy, vitality, and happiness. Every day is a new opportunity to improve your health and get the most out of life.
Hey everyone, welcome. My new book, 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier, and blessed to have you with us today and have my three favorite people in the world, Victoria, our daughter Alexandra, our daughter-in-law, beautiful Sophia. And so we're just going to have a moment to talk and share a little bit, but just blessed to have you. One of the chapters in the book is called Nothing to Prove. And it feels like today, more than ever, there's comparison. There's, you know, it's easy to live in a proving mode. Let me show you, I got a bigger church than you. I got this or that. But you do that, you put so much pressure on ourselves. And the principle of the book is our emotional well-being affects our physical well-being. And, you know, when you live in these modes of pressure and outperforming and outdoing, it's not good for your health and it's not good for your well-being. But anyway, thanks for being with us. I can't believe I got y'all to do this.
I know.
This took a lot of favor, but
I found out last night, to be fair.
I know. I thought I'd ask her like a month ago, and I forgot to ask her because I knew you would do
it. You did mention it, but yeah, what's tomorrow?
No, thank y'all for doing it. But we'll come back to that. But you got beautiful little Rooney. So Sophia, we're so blessed to have you in the family like a year and.
Yes.
A year and a couple months ago, you and Jonathan got married. That's awesome.
It's crazy how fast the time has gone. but it's so sweet. I love you guys.
Oh, thank you.
Y'all dated for like 3.5 years.
Yeah, 3 or 3.5 years.
And you met at Disneyland, right?
Yeah.
Through a mutual friend?
Met at Disneyland through a mutual friend. And then I think Jonathan had a crush on me for a couple of years. And I had no idea.
I can confirm.
Yeah, he did. And then when we went back.
Shows you that timing is everything.
Yeah, that's true.
When we went back for that night of hope, that's when he, you know, reconnected back with you. We sat on that porch right back there and calculated ways of how can I get this girl to like me right on that porch. It was fun.
Which is hilarious because I'm so direct, I would have just asked. But when I heard all the backstory, I was like, this is so funny.
You're a twin. You have a
yes.
beautiful twin
Rudy.
Sister, Helena. Come on, guys. And then you got a beautiful Ellie
older
as well.
Sister, yeah.
Yeah, so you got two beautiful sisters. But Alexandra, you've been with us our whole life.
I have.
you're heading up Lakewood Music now, but let's get on the book and then we'll come back to this stuff. But so, do y'all feel that pressure that in you know, especially in your age group, it seems like I said more than ever.
Yeah, I mean, I think comparison is a real thing that everyone deals with. I've definitely felt the pressure before and like fallen into that mode of comparing on social media or in real life. And for me, I think it's something I have to constantly remind myself doesn't serve me. You know, like everyone runs their own race, has their own journey. And I love to look at what other people do for inspiration. And whenever it goes beyond that, it turns to comparison, having to just like check yourself and be like, this doesn't help me get any better to just feel bad about myself because someone else is doing great. But it's not easy. Like I said, for me, it's a daily thing. I feel like a lot of things in life, it's a daily choice to not compare and to just be content and trusting God that where you are is where you're supposed to be.
How can you tell that, you know, do you get frustrated? How do you know that, okay, wait a minute, I got to stop because I feel like I'm letting, you know, myself get too worked up about either my future or I'm not going fast enough or I'm not, you know, doing enough comparing, you know, especially when you compare, do you find yourself getting frustrated or how do you guide that? How do you monitor that?
Yeah, I think when you're frustrated, when you feel anxiety about a situation, about like how your future is going to go out or what this project is going to, how it's going to turn out. I'm like, this is coming from somewhere that's not God, because God wouldn't put anxiety in my life. God wouldn't put this comparison in my life. So that's, if it's negative, then I'm like, okay, let's see where this is coming from.
Yeah, that's not healthy. That's what your book talks about. Mm-hmm. So.
What about you, Sophia?
Yeah, I think it's so easy with this day and age, with especially social media. You know, everybody wants to look like they have the best life and post all the happy moments. So I think you, like Alexandra said, it's a daily task of like checking yourself, checking where you're at. And even just those things of like, you know, anxiety and thinking about the future. I always say just day by day, you know, God gives you what you need for each day.
Right.
And I always remind myself of that. And if I'm feeling that anxiety or that stress, just like take it today. Mm-hmm. You can focus on tomorrow. So
you're really good at that, Sophia. Even transitioning into this family, you've transitioned so easily and joyful. But that, I guess that's your nature. But I was going to say that must not have been easy, but I hope it's easy.
You guys made it easier for sure. But yeah, it was a big change, you know, moving from California. So that definitely helps me, just taking it day by day, step by step, not thinking too much ahead. But now I'm here and I live here, so now it's home.
Yeah, that's fun. That's beautiful. Alexandra, you head up Lakewood Music at the church, and y'all toured. You went on tour with Torin for all those dates, and we all laughed because Alexandra lived in a tour bus for 2 weeks or a month or something like that, but with a bunch of guys, well, a bunch of girls too. But
yeah, more guys than girls.
Yeah, lived in that, I got in her little bunk and it's amazing.
Oh,
that
it was
little...
so funny. When we got home to Houston, my dad picked me up and I was like, you got to come get in my bunk. And he's like, comes and we get everything on. He like lays there and he was like, is that how you sleep?
I know.
But he said it was comfortable.
It was comfortable.
Like, you wanna do it?
It seemed fun, but that's great. And then the music y'all are putting out is fantastic. The new album's going to come out here pretty soon. Well, it's next year, but I've heard some of the songs, but it's really fantastic. But I love what y'all are doing.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's such a great group of people, and it's so fun to be able to do music that represents Lakewood, that comes from the heart of our church. Like, that's what everything is based out of, you know, what we believe at Lakewood. And so many songs are based off messages you speak, things I hear my mom say and everything. That's what we want to do. That's what we feel like part of our goal is, you know. Yeah, so
that's so good. Victoria, how do you handle all the pressure and the comparison and all that stuff, my love?
Well, you know what? My favorite thing is to hang out with these two girls right here. And so, you know, I learned so much. You know, sometimes you have a lot to give, but also I think we have a lot to learn. And I love the fact that Sophia and Alexander love to laugh. I love to laugh. And we just have good talks. And so I learn a lot about the youth and young people and the way they think. And
we teach her things.
Y'all teach me things.
We
y'all
really teach me things. Educate her.
But they get mad if I try to buy their tennis shoes or anything like that.
No, the same tennis shoes.
She likes to copy us. She's comparing herself to us.
That's not true.
She's trying to prove that she's 18 or 22 or whatever.
That's not true. But sometimes, you know, they'll have something cute like shoes. I'll go, oh, I like those shoes. And the first thing they say, don't get a pair.
Alexandra helps me too with my messages. What was that the other
thing? Your messages.
With what I say. I call people a lot of young ladies. She said, don't call us young ladies. No,
he didn't
please.
Say young lady. He just said lady. And lady. I was like, that just doesn't seem like what you want it to say.
I don't know. It's fun. We like to laugh. And you know, the fact is that, you know, the scripture says laughter is like a medicine. And I think that's one thing that all of y'all have is a easygoing spirit and a relaxed atmosphere. I've told you before, I hear Victoria laughing all through the house, and it echoes through the house. And so, Sophia, you're so good natured. Alexandra's a planner like me. You're good natured. Alexandra's a lot of fun, but she's a planner like me, and we have so much in common in that we're both prepared. Not that y'all aren't prepared, but overly prepared probably.
Hey,
but,
we know who we are.
We're going with the flow.
Y'all go with the flow. Well, the book is 15 ways to live longer and healthier.
15 ways to go with the flow. No, the truth is, you know what I love though? I love the fact that like, Alexander's never had a sister. You have two sisters. And so I love the fact that, you know, you guys get along so well and mm-hmm. that y'all can just talk. We went to a wedding the other day and we had connecting rooms. And so they were in one room and I was in one room and I could hear them laughing and just chatting. And I think that was one of the most fun things about the whole wedding experience was just listening to them chat and laugh. And we all got to put our makeup on together and everything, but it just brings me so much joy to see my kids happy and joyful. And so how's it been to have a sister-in-law? How does that feel?
I love it. It's great. No complaints.
Do you?
We were kind of roommates, too, for a little bit before Jonathan and I got married. So that was, like, special.
Yeah.
We would wake up and be like, morning.
That's right. You lived with us for almost a year.
Yeah.
Which was so good for the transition.
It really was. I think it made it a lot easier. And it was special to, like, spend that time with you guys, too.
Yeah. Yeah. So nice. I love that so much.
It was fun. Uzi, I'm going to ask you. Oh, Uzi, I was going to ask you, can you tilt down and show our dog?
Oh, yeah. You're like
Rooney, you're on camera, buddy. Come here, Rooney. Come here, Rooney. You want to come? Y'all can't see her face.
That's the audience right there. It's our audience.
All right. Okay. Sorry, y'all.
How is it to, like, work in a, you know, with different types of people and not, and like, we just got this question is like, how do you express your opinion without, you know, being defensive or wanting people to buy into it? I know that's a big question, but
I mean, I think you just do everything with kindness. And if you have a good heart and you come from a good place, people can understand. And I think if you intentionally build good relationships with the people you work with, then.
Oh, that's a good point.
You know, they can understand where you're coming from and they can have a respect for you even if you disagree about a situation.
Yeah, I feel like it's your motive.
Yeah.
Like, if you're doing it in a harsh way, you know, people aren't going to really like that or accept it. Mm-hmm. They're going to think you're kind of a mean person.
Yeah.
But if it's coming from your heart and you're saying it and conveying it in a good way, I think it, you know, can come across kindly. And
yeah, because some people just want their way to get their way.
Yeah.
You know, but if you're open to, you know, listen to other people and they see your heart, you want the same thing. You want to get to the same goal. So I love that. That's a good point, though, building those relationships with your coworkers and knowing that there will be times you have to make decisions together.
That's so good. Sophia, what's it like living in Houston for you, coming from California?
I love it.
You do?
Yeah, it feels like home now.
Oh, that's
so good. I have my little places that I go to. It feels, it's funny because California has always been my home and I've grown up there. But now I feel like that's almost like a second home or like a vacation when I go now. And this is like home, my home base. So
good.
It's sweet. It's definitely hotter, but it's okay.
And you know, I think it's interesting because when y'all dated, y'all talked about where you would live if this relationship went on. And so you all talked about things that were, you know, very important to your relationship, so there were no surprises like that. So I think that's so great. What do you think about that dating and how to, you know, you need to plan that kind
totally.
Of stuff out.
Yeah, I think about. Clear communication is key. And to have, you know, some of those conversations aren't like super fun to have at the beginning because you're like in love and it's so fun. You know, you're so fun. You're on cloud nine. But I think those are obviously so important. Some of those key aspects, like what do you value? You know, what are your beliefs? All that type of stuff is really what made me like fall in love with Jonathan even more.
Yeah.
So.
And Jonathan's a good talker, huh?
He is. Really? Sometimes I think he talks more than I do. But only to me.
Remember that little young person that told you when you were first dating Jonathan said, remember that line, what are your intentions?
Yes.
I thought that was pretty interesting. Just
he's like 9 years old and I was leaving. I nannied for him and he was like, he knew I was going on a date and he was like, make sure to ask him what his intentions are with you. And I was like, what?
And then you did.
And I did. I used that as my gateway on that story because I thought it was funny. And Jonathan was taken aback. He was like, whoa.
I'm an 8-year-old boy. That's amazing.
That's cute.
Well, Alexander, when does the album come out? Is it next year?
Next summer, hopefully. But yes, we'll be having a live recording at the church the first of the year, so.
And a lot of the songs that we sing at Lakewood, not all of them, but a lot of them are the new Lakewood Music songs. It's really fantastic what y'all have done and just the talent and the just, I love them, so.
Good. Well, I'm glad you love them.
So we're going to do, we'll do a live recording in the first of the year. Mm-hmm. Wow, that's awesome. Yeah. Well, now, thanks for doing this with us today.
Yeah, will y'all do more of this with us? Because it's so much more fun.
Only if Alexander does it.
Yeah, we're a package deal.
Yeah, we did an at home, and sometimes our at home gets a little bit boring.
We need some life. Fresh new blood in our at homes, for sure.
Guys, we love you. The book is 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier, and just our goal is that you become all God's created you to be and that you do live healthy. And so, you know, one thing I can take from these people around me, these people that I love, is they have a relaxed attitude. They trust that God's in control. They're joyful. And that's a big part of living healthy is having, you know, laughter and joy, and it just releases the stress. So I hope that, and, you know, again, not living to prove. This is a day where, you know, can we outperform and all that, you know what, run your race like you guys said so beautifully. And even when you said that, Alexander, I thought about, you know, when my dad died, I felt like I had to be like my dad because, you know, people that were coming to church, they'd been there for 40 years. I thought, Joy, you better be like your dad. But, you know, I love my dad and I respect him. But I realized after about a month or two, I can't preach like my dad and lead like my dad and be like my dad as much as I love him. When I stepped into who God called me to be, that's when the church really began to grow. And so just think, you know, you're anointed to be you. You're not anointed to be anybody else. And you have everything you need to fulfill your destiny. And I think when you embrace that, and what you guys said too, you're inspired by other people that are further ahead, but not intimidated by them. Man, celebrate them. God did it for them. He can do it for you, but run your race. But
that's good.
Enough of that, guys. I hope we see you again tomorrow for our next 15 minutes. But we love you. We're praying for you. And we just speak God's very best over you and your family.
Need more energy? Want more happiness in your life? Want to be healthier and live longer?
To live long and healthy, to have plenty of energy and vitality, that's what we all want. The good news is, that's God's dream for your life as well, but we have to get in agreement with Him. Our emotional well-being affects our physical well-being.
When we live worried, stressed, or bitter, it weakens our immune system. It won't fight off disease like it should.
That's why I wrote my new book. I'll show you 15 things you can do to live healthier and longer. You can get up each morning with more energy,
You can go to work with more vitality. You can be free from what's limiting your life.
You owe it to yourself and your family to be strong and healthy. Your first priority is to take care of yourself.
I know these principles work. I've used them in my own life. I still feel like I'm in my 20s. The scripture talks about how our youth can be renewed. That's our prayer for you, that you will feel younger, have plenty of energy, and live a long, vibrant life.
As you support the mission of Joel Osteen Ministries with a gift of any amount this month, we would like to give you a copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier. Studies have shown that prolonged stress can damage your health. However, when you are full of hope and joy, your immune system functions at its peak performance, just as God has intended. Your health can be restored, and energy to enjoy your life and family can return. And in this book, you'll explore how to have a calmer soul, a more focused mind, and you will learn to let go and how to best take care of yourself.
We don't always realize how much our emotions and attitudes are affecting us physically. If you want to be healthy, you have to make sure your soul is healthy.
I'd love to send you a copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier. We want you to feel better than ever, have more energy, more vitality, so you can become all you were created to be. Victoria and I pray for you and your family every day. Thank you so much for your support and your prayer. Your generosity is making a difference in people's lives around the world. Special thank you to our Champion of Hope partners for your monthly support. If you're not a partner, I hope you'll consider becoming one. Remember, you can watch the services live online every Sunday. You can download our daily podcast. Until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you.
Be sure to request your copy of 15 Ways to Live Longer and Healthier today. Visit joelosteen.com or call 888-567-JOEL. Also this month, for additional donation, we have our Abundant Life Journal and Pen Set. You can write down what you need to let go of and declare new health that God is blessing you with. Also, our Abundant Life wall art gift is a beautiful reminder of the amazing life God has for you. You can learn more about these life-giving gifts by calling 888-567-JOEL or logging on to joelosteen.com today. As you absorb these 15 ways to live longer and healthier, you'll experience a truly blessed life. Order your copy today and start each morning with more energy, vitality, and happiness. Every day is a new opportunity to improve your health and get the most out of life.